So the thing we've all been waiting for is finally here. Burn the Witch has dropped. I won't say officially, but at the moment we have the leaks and scans for Burn the Witch in issue of 38, because I got it wrong on Twitter and I said 39, but that's because we had leaks of this magazine's next issue, which is going to be chapter 2 of Burn the Witch, which will, if you haven't seen Twitter already, which you should follow me on as James Hansen, there is going to be, 37 pages, I believe, for next issue, so all good. Epic. But let's talk about this one, because we've had three images, one being the front cover of Shonen Jump, which I'm going to be picking up straight away as soon as that's officially in stores. I'm grabbing it. So that's going to be a banger. And then obviously we have the lead color page, which is a double spread. And that has Noelle and Nini. And we'll talk about that in a minute, because you know how I'm gonna be feeling about that. And then we have the anime information. I say that very lightly and I'll address why. We have an anime visual to show that, which I believe we're going to be having a preview very, very shortly, which looks gorgeous. So let's look at the front cover. What can we see? Basically, I was almost fooled with this. I don't believe that this is Kubo's artwork. I don't know whose it is. I haven't translated the whole cover. We'll probably find out very, very shortly today or tomorrow or whenever the issue comes out. So I'll address it. But either way, they almost had me. Unfortunately, Kubo doesn't draw his lines quite as round as this person or this mangaka has done right here. But it's very nice. It's very commemorative. I really enjoy it. I think it looks well. I can see a little bit of Nini's booty shorts, and it's a banger. Again, this is a great front cover, to be quite honest with you. It just is. But I think what got me, like, Noelle, all right. But, like, Nini, she looked a bit too round for me, and I was like, okay, this ain't Kubo's. But it's a banger. Like, I appreciate this. This is, like, it's just awesome. Like, I'm actually talking about something on the front cover again, and it's a madness. It's mad. So, yeah, 57 pages, as it says on the bottom there. There's not really much to go on here. If anything, the only thing I could really translate on this front cover was something like a huge rising star with a sure release, a huge meteor show, a new series of four releases. So there's going to be, like, four new series that are going to be dropping. And then it says, like, series has four episodes, which is four chapters, a cover and intro color with 57 pages. It's basically the kind of relevant stuff with Burn the Witch on this cover. So on to the next one. So, I mean, hey, look, this is a visual. It has Burgo, the dog. Okay, so here's the thing. Yeah, and this is my speculation here. This is what I'm going to drop here. I mean, besides Nini giving me the bad bitch there. And I love Nini. Look at that. Like, she got little hands on her pockets, booty shorts out, thigh highs up. Yo, she give me that bad bitch vibe. This is like, this is it. It's just going to be me simping over Nini for the majority of these four chapters. And I'm okay with this. Noelle looking fig. Noelle just looking fit. I mean, just look at her. She looks amazing. She's vibing. I don't know what they're standing on. It seems like they're standing on top of a building, a tower building or a chimney. I don't know. It looks like, yeah, it just looks like it says, don't something dragons, let's eat animals. I don't know. I want to see the clean version of that. But don't eat animals. I mean, yeah, don't something dragons, though. Don't attack dragon. I don't know. But you have Virgo or Bargo, however you want to, like, pronounce it. I think it's Virgo. Virgo over there chilling with the dragon dog. Now, this is what's interesting. If you've read the one-shot, and I'm quite confused on how this chapter is going to go. Are we going to have, like, a rehash of, like, the one-shot? Is that going to be, like, chapter zero, and then this is going to carry on from onwards? It seems like that's probably going to be the case, and have that as chapter zero, and this is chapter one. Again, one-shot, chapter... Yeah, I mean, it's happened before. It's really weird, because I want to see what Burgo does in this regard, and in his relevance to the story, because, like, at the end of, like, the one-shot, you see that, like, they say, hey, this Geese or this human is your responsibility now. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the dog died. So I'm like, the dragon came out of the fucking dog, and then they defeated the dragon. So what's going on with the doggo now? So that's going to be funny, I suppose. It's going to be interesting to see. But this whole perspective, people that say Kubo can't do backgrounds, I mean, obviously it's ignorance, but like, this goes to prove, like, the perspectives. Everything's kind of reversed really nicely, too. Like, there's a lot of, like, architecture here, which is really fascinating to me. So, Kubo really, like, did a really good job in showing that architecture and not just proportions, but also perspective as well. So, really vibe with this. The colouring's great and the poses are amazing. Nini, hey. Hey, girl. How you doing? Hey. Anyway, sorry. Oh, fuck. I'm gonna get bullied. As well, I didn't even say what the translation was on the page. It's actually nothing really much going on there either. It just says 4-episode series from legendary, you know, mangaka Kubo. And it says something along the lines of the continuation of the drawing starts on page 27. For animation info, please go to the next page. So it's just basically saying, hey, here's your cover page. If you want to read the chapter, it's on page 27. And if you want more animation news, it's on the next page. Which, here's the disappointing part, there's not that much news, and I think there's going to be another page, but let's talk about that now. Right, now, I don't know whether to feel, like, kind of targeted or triggered by this, because I'm a Brit, so, like, this is kind of weird, because, like, they've done this newspaper, Big Ben, the House of Commons, House of Lords kind of shit going on here, Monday the 24th of August as the newspaper title. I thought that was actually pretty cool, I did enjoy that, and the Reverse London Press. I mean, it's cute, it's quirky. This is the animation. Now, we saw the PV. The PV looked all right. I did enjoy the PV. The art style was interesting. But we didn't get to see too much, if that makes sense. It was nice for a teaser. And again, I think we're going to get a PV very soon. But this, in general, whoever did the character designs really slapped with this. Because, I mean, look at Nini. Yet again, the hair is amazing. It doesn't look as flat as I thought it would do. Noelle looks great too. I mean, there's not really much to say about Noelle. I would say there's more going on with Nini because of the hair and the fluttering of the scarf and just the design in general. They gave her a chest, which is quite interesting. and besides from that, that's got to be CG. No, it's a PV. No, it's not a PV. It's an artwork, James. It wouldn't, if that's CG or hand drawn, that's a banger. They did Big Ben really, really fucking good there. And the roads. You can see Bargo again with the doggo. So that's going to be interesting what this man's going to do. It seems like he's going to be using the dog as his like weapon or his transportation, which is going to be fascinating. That's it. Like, it's just a really cool thing to see. The translation itself just says the Reverse London Press, Monday, August 24th, 2020. And that's it. That's literally just it. I mean, quite literally, underneath Nini's dragon wing, it literally just says fly the dragon, flying in the sky, visual animation, world premiere, and that's it. So I feel like there's going to be another page. There's obviously going to be a lot more stuff. These are just like new leaks. And just as I finished recording, there was more leaked news of what there was that I thought was missing. So yes, we have as you can see on screen right now, the translation says, and this is to go to talk about the distribution of the movie, which is going to be interesting to talk about, to speculate on, because I've got a few things to say about this, but the translation says, the series' serialized contents from this issue will be animated as soon as possible. Experience the story of Burn the Witch on the big screen. Event screening and worldwide distribution will start on Friday on October 2nd, 2020. Now, I'm going to say that's a little bit scarce on translation. I want to double check on this one, but if so, we're going to discuss it anyway. Burn the Witch will be made into an animation at the same time as the series. The anime will be screened at the theater for 2 weeks from October 2nd. Furthermore, it is a little different from the contents of the theater. The edited versions of the non-Amazon Prime version will be distributed worldwide from the same day. In Japan, it can be viewed from Amazon Prime Video and Hikari TV. For more details, go to the official website. So I'm gonna shoot a limb here and have a gander's at what this is saying, if the translation is correct. I did assume that it was going to be Netflix that's going to have Burn the Witch, the movie, but it seems to me that it might be Crunchyroll now. It's up in the air, but I think I'm going to go towards Crunchyroll at the moment. So I would assume that, especially as I've been seeing Crunchyroll promote a lot of Bleach recently, I think they've nabbed it, to be quite honest with you. But hey, whatever. It seems that we're going to be getting the OVA, whether it's Netflix or whether it's Crunchyroll, on a worldwide scale. So that's been decided, and that's amazing. Wherever we watch it is wherever we watch it. We'll be able to watch it almost simultaneously. On the same day or at the same time. I think it's a good idea that they haven't actually just made it theater exclusive only with all the COVID-19 stuff going on right now. So I think they've made a very good decision here, and I'm very excited. I think the question for me is which version is edited, the one at the theater or the one on the streaming services? I want to try and watch both. I think I will do like a comparison video. I just want to reread this. The anime will be screened at the theater for 2 weeks from October 2nd. Furthermore, it is a little different from the contents of the theatre. The edited version of the non-Amazon Prime version will be distributed worldwide on the same day. So basically, you want to get Amazon Prime, is what I'm hearing. We'll see. I wonder what's edited. Oh, is it the blood? Is it like maybe some lewd panty shots? Like what's it? We'll see when we read the manga. We'll read the manga because obviously the manga will finish before we've actually seen the movie or the OVA. So this is why I said it was an OVA, because it was a bit weird on how it was going to be distributed. So I was never wrong in that regard, but it was interesting because you never really, like, OVAs usually come with like a DVD or with some manga as like a separate thing, but it can be on the theaters, just like the Kuroko no Basket or the Attack on Titan compilation movies. Like, they're kind of, it's weird. So it kind of makes sense that at the same time they're putting it out there as well as on theater. So like the movie OVA thing makes sense, you know, it's just a play on words, I suppose you could say, from Japan's part. But there's news on that. And back to past James. Again, I'll be the next video will probably be about spoilers of the chapter itself. We'll probably get some scans here and there, so we're going to throw some predictions of what's going to go on, like get a conversation going, get some little hype build up ready for chapter one to drop on Sunday at the official Viz time. So very excited. If you want to see more about my thoughts or if I get some new information, please check out the Discord in the description down below. And of course, follow me on Twitter. And if you also would like to see me read Burn the Witch in live reaction, non-edited, compared to the edited version that will be live on YouTube, please go check out the Patreon as well. For $10, you can see unedited, everything on screen, and no copyright issues. And the same goes for when we live react to the live action movie as well. And you get to see the reaction before everyone else does on YouTube. So there you go. Nini, hello. Hey, girl. I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Be the handsome as always, people. Peace out.